Welcome. I recorded this new tutorial to show you how to use the GDB debugger and compiler in Atom in Windows. Since a lot of you had problems with my previous video, I realized the reason is simply because I develop a lot in Linux. I find Linux is much better suited for the development purposes than Windows, but a lot of you are still using Windows, which is also great for you. I don't mind. I think it's a good idea if you are familiar with it. So what you need to do first is you need to download and install the TDM-GCC package, which is a min-GW, which provides you basically executables for GDB and GCC. So these are a lot of GNU tools that are basically compiled for the Windows purpose. And all you need to do is on the left-hand side to click on download. And once you click on download, you need to choose which version to install. There is a 64-bit version and the 32-bit only version. The 64-bit version supports as well 32-bit, and I believe most computers since 2005 can do 64-bit. So just take this version, install it, and you will be fine. Now you will have all the tools necessary to develop under Windows. Once you have done that, you can now run Atom. And in Atom, we have to install two packages. It takes a moment. By the way, the whole description that I now give to you, you will find in the description underneath of this video. So now what we need to do is we need to install these two packages. So I click here on the file settings, install to manage the Atom packages. There I type dbg-gdb, which stands for debugging of GDB. You can look what this kind of system provides for you, this package, but there's nothing you need to set up, you need to configure. For me, it works out of the box. So the second package we need is to actually provide and link the compiler, the GCC compiler in this case, with Atom. So therefore, we have gcc-make-run package, and here we should adjust the settings a bit. Since you want to debug, it's very useful to change the default flags, the default compiler flags. You don't have to change anything in the settings, which I just show you here. For me, it again finds the compiler automatically. In the compiler flags, I add -wall, which stands for warnings all enabled, quite useful for the compilation process, and -g gdb to add debugging symbols, which is actually very mandatory if you want to run it with a debugger. In this case, we want to use the GDB debugger, that's quite useful to run -g gdb. -o0 means I disable optimization. Once you have changed these flags and used them by default, what you need to do is you need to actually create a project. And therefore I said add project folder, and I create here a new project folder, which is just a new folder. And let me call this one my project. Okay, so this is absolutely empty at the moment. So I need to create a C file by right clicking here, saying new file, and I call it test.c. Let me add a little bit of boilerplate. Here standard io.h for printing something on the standard output. And here our main function, which doesn't do anything yet. But let me add here now a function that recursively calls itself and basically produces a failure because of a stack overflow. Okay, we call this function func and add int a as an argument, and we call func a plus 1 inside this function, so it will call itself forever until our stack overflow happens. Since I won't see anything on the terminal, let me add here printf. And in this printf, I type before func, and then that you can see that this actually crashes, I type after func. So let me now compile this. Therefore, you can right click and say compile run or use F6. You can also change this compilation flags by using control F6. But as you can see, it actually runs GCC with the appropriate arguments, and then it automatically runs. It only prints before func because, as I said, it actually crashes this our application. So this is, of course, the case where you want to have a debugger at hand, right? So let me try to now debug this. First of all, I insert here a breakpoint, which you can do with F9, or right click and say toggle breakpoint here. And this is quite sensible because I saw before func printed, but not after func, right? So our traditional print of debugging kind of works. So now you, you could right click here on this executable and say debug this file, which is a way of doing what I showed you before. You run with F5 and then you try to choose file. For whatever reason, I don't know, choose file doesn't work. So path to the file to debug is always empty. I have no clue why this happens under Windows, but it's the case. So the right way to make it work under Windows is to right click and then say debug this file. As you can see, now this path is properly filled and now I can click debug. So let me do that. And it will start to run the application, and invoking the GDB debugger, it will stop in this line. And on the right side, we see the call stack. Let me close on the left-hand side our project folder. And on the bottom, we see the output of the debugger. It is now in breakpoint 1, and this line of code. And here's our call stack. We have only the main function, and I can now step into this function. And I see here the variable. And every variable that's on the stack. So A is filled at the moment with 5. And I see on the right side on the call stack that func is called in this line, and there's a main function underneath on the stack and stack frame. So now I can step into it again, and I see 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 12, and so on. A increments until the function would fail. And on the right side, you can see on the call stack, there are all these functions put on the stack. And it's quite nice because whenever you click on it, the stack variables, they actually change, which gives you a nice overview what these values are actually. So that's, I think, the most features that you have with this package from Atom. I think it's a great starting point for learning C and, of course, C++ too, and to use the GNU tools. However, this is a very basic compiler. The GDB compiler on command line has, of course, much more features. It's much more powerful.